So today we are assigned this problem here, graph f of theta equals negative 3 cosecant 2 theta plus 1. Now, graphing this is real complicated by itself, but if we simplify it to its parent function, it's a much simpler equation. The way we're going to do this is using the unit circle. So, first of all, every trigonometric function is a ratio. So this one, cosecant, is actually hypotenuse over opposite. And if you remember, this is from the whole right triangle sides. So this long one is called the hypotenuse. This, if you're measuring from here, this one is the opposite. So this corner here is theta, and then this one underneath is adjacent. So the first thing that we're going to want to find is the asymptotes related to this function. So where will this function not be able to be seen, or where will it not be able to equal a number? And that will always happen when there is a number, any kind of number, over 0, because we can't divide by 0. Imagine having one apple to divide among 0 people. It just doesn't work. So the first place that occurs is here. And that is because, if you can imagine this being a triangle like this, where this line here is the hypotenuse, and we're measuring from this angle here, being theta. This side here is then the opposite. And this side is the hypotenuse. That opposite is equal to 0.01. And we have our hypotenuse, which is going to be 1, and whenever dealing with unit circles, we're always using hypotenuse as 1. And that, but when we divide like this, it's going to end up being quite a large number. This one is in fact 100. To do 0.001 over 1, that's equal to 1,000. Fit that in. All right, great. Totally not squishing it there. And it will get even closer and closer until it hits 0. But when it hits 0, no number can equal that. No matter what your number is, over 0, it is always going to end up not working out. And that happens at pi. This here is pi because this is considered 2 pi. This is pi over 2. And this is just pi. The other place that this will happen is, of course, over here on this line. For the same exact reason. If we're measuring from this angle here, theta, and this is opposite, and this is hypotenuse, the same thing can happen. When it reaches 0, just breaks it. It'll never actually hit pi or 2 pi because those are the asymptotes, but it'll get really close. In fact, it'll get infinitely close. But also, it will continue vertically to infinity. It'll never stop. The closer you get, the higher on the graph it's going to be. And that's really what we're doing, is we're finding these ratios, and we're plugging it into a graph, and we're just putting the points on it so we can see what that design will look like. For example, sine will look something like this. What happens if we're measuring from here? So, say that we're just barely off that mark, and we're actually measuring from a line right here. Triangle, to be able to use our trigonometric functions, we have to imagine that there's a line here, and then we can then plot the points. So opposite now is really close to 1, so let's say it's 0.9. And then hypotenuse will still be 1. 1. So what happens with 0.9 over 1? Well, that's really close to 1. And in fact, when we get to 1, which will be this vertical line, because the opposite will be 1, and the hypotenuse will also be 1, but here the adjacent will be 0. But we're not measuring with adjacent, so 1 over 1, that is actually 1. So we know now that as we approach this mark, pi over 2, we're getting closer and closer to 1. At pi over 2, we will be at 1. That's one point we can use. But we also know, for now, that the asymptote is at pi and every increment of pi. So pi over or pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, so on and so forth. Beyond the asymptotes are at pi and 2 pi. And they're also at negative pi. But also, or 2 pi is the exact same thing as saying 0 pi. Because as you go around the circle, it just repeats. So hit pi perfectly there. But what happens at point 9? We do 1, which is going to be our hypotenuse, over point 9. Gives us 1.1111 repeating. So that is at point 9, which is going to be right here, going to be another one at point 111 repeating. So that's going to be just next to it. Let's say this is 0.9 over. So, or this line here is going to be 0.9. It's going to be real close to 1, but not quite. That's going to give us 1.1 repeating. Then what's going to happen when we go negative, actually, into this area that we have not touched yet? 2 pi over 3. Hypotenuse is 1, because it's always going to be 1, but our opposite now is going to be negative 1. So 1 and 1, but it's going to be a negative opposite. So that's going to end up equaling negative 1. Now we can go plug that in around about there. So let's go back to our unit circle, and here we'll try plugging in a negative opposite like 0.9. So let's say that our triangle's hypotenuse is here, and that our opposite is here. This is now opposite, but it's a negative. Now it's going to be 1 over 0.9, which this is completely wrong. I don't know why I messed up on that. It should be hypotenuse over opposite, not opposite over hypotenuse. This time, it's going to be negative. That means it's going to be negative 1.11 repeating. That's going to be here. So let's imagine we do the exact same thing, except on the other side of the unit circle. This length here will be 0.9. And this will still be the hypotenuse of 1. So as we know, it's going to be hypotenuse, which is 1, over 0.9, which is going to give us the exact same ratio we had earlier. But now let's try several other numbers. Let's do 0.5 instead of 1 over 0.5. Let's make that here. That's going to be there. That's going to be along this line that's already drawn for us. And this here is going to be 0.5. That's the opposite. And this is still 1, hypotenuse. Let's pull up our calculator. 1 over 0.5 is 2. We know that it's going to be not just on one side, but on both sides of this, the lowest point, it's going to be 1.1. And we know here, the same thing is going to happen. We also know that it's going to be way up here when it's really close to this asymptote. That was what we figured out when we were doing those asymptotes. And same thing over here, in fact. As we approach it from the negative side, it's going to have the same effect. 45 degrees between pi and 3 pi over 2. Knowing that, we can now roughly draw a graph that looks somewhat like this. I'm going to continue on, much like that, and oh, same thing here, actually. We plug in the same points, and we could find the same places that are going to be between 2 pi, or pi over 2 and pi. Exactly halfway between, in fact. And we can then draw our graph. Now, this is just our cosecant, and so far it looks like we are correct, which is going to be pi over 2, it's at 1, and that is precisely what we drew. And it's going to be the asymptote. Let's try plugging in. That is just where it is missed. You can can see that there. Oh no. We have to consider that it's not just this equation, f of theta equals cosecant theta. That's just the parent function. We have some transformations to it. So if we get that and we pull up our original equation, what's going to happen when we add the transformations negative 3 and 2 theta plus 1? Ultimately, what is plus 1 going to do? It's going to take all our outputs and it's going to move everything up 1. It's going to look exactly the same shape, except it's going to be shifted just slightly up. So that negative 3 is going to make things a little bit strange. So instead of just being at 1, it's going to amplify that, and it's going to be at 3. So our original equation was at 1, now it's going to be at 3. But since we added 1, it's actually going to be at 4. And in fact, the negative makes this one move all the way up here. It flips, because every number is now multiplied by a negative number, so it becomes the negatives become positive, and the positive becomes negative. That 2 is going to be real tricky. Multiplying theta by 2, which ultimately has the effect of dividing by 2. And pi, and then this is going to be at negative 2, so 1, 2. Because we have the 3 in there that flips it, instead of being up here where it originally was, we have the negative 3, which also then amplifies it. And then we add the plus 1 in there, and it ultimately ends up being here. And we have our points that go kind of like this, continue on to negative infinity, and here. Up here, it's actually starting at the positive 4. Because we have the 3, so it would have originally been multiplied out 3, and that causes a vertical shift, or a vertical stretch, and that ultimately leads us to being there. But then we added the extra 1, so it moves the entire thing up by 1, and that leaves us right there. It's going to look very similar to the negative 1, except be inverted, so it goes to positive infinity instead of negative infinity. And it'll, of course, never actually hit our pi. And it'll continue this pattern, staying along the same axis this way, always going to be at negative 2, never going to go past it. Shoot. It's going to have asymptotes every pi over 2. This one is actually 3 pi over 2 here.